Welcome everybody, my name is Ola El Husseini. In this tutorial, I am going to show you how to display the subtotal by using macro. In this example, we have sheet. This sheet contains the sales transaction for the product, and I want when I press a button, the subtotal for each brand will be displayed. And if I press another one, the subtotal for each product will be displayed. And if I press a button, the subtotal for each product and its related product will be displayed. And if I press a button, the subtotal will be removed as we see. Okay, before I show you how to do this, please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell button to receive the upcoming videos. Now, let me show you how to do this. The first step, I am going to create a new macro. This macro will display the subtotal for each brand and its related product name. Okay, so to create a new macro, you have to click the developer tab and record the macro. Then type a name for your macro and be sure the macro name doesn't include a space or dot or dash. Okay. And press OK. The second step, we have to select any cell in the header row, okay, for instance E4, okay, and then I want to sort the data by the brand column, then its related product name. So I have to click data tab, then sort command, okay. And be sure my data has headers is selected, okay. And from sort by, okay, select the main column, in this case the brand column, and I want to sort it from A to Z, okay. And then by, I want to sort the data by the product name, and also I want to sort it from A to Z, okay. Then press OK. Now the data is sorted by the brand column, then by its related product name. Okay, the second step, I am going to create the subtotal. Okay, so I click the data tab and subtotal from the outline group. From add each change in drop down list, select brand column because I want to display the subtotal for it. And from use function drop down list, there is multiple function. The default function is sum. Okay. And I want to display the subtotal for the total column. So be sure to check this column. Okay. And I want, if there is another previous subtotal, I want to remove it. So be sure to check this option, replace current subtotal. Okay, and I want to display the subtotal plus the data. So be sure the summary plus data is selected and press OK. Now I display the subtotal for each brand as we see. Okay, the second step, I want to display the subtotal for the for each product, okay, related to its brand. Okay, so click data tab and subtotal command from the outline group, and from add each change in drop down list, select product name because I want to display the subtotal for it. And from use function drop down list, be sure to select some function. Okay, and I want to display the subtotal for the total column, so be sure this column is selected. And I don't want to replace the previous subtotal, so uncheck replace current subtotal option. Okay, and press OK. Now I display the subtotal for each brand and its related product. Okay, the last step, I am going to stop recording the macro. So I click developer tab, then stop recording. Okay, the next step, I want to create a macro to display only the subtotal for each product. Okay, so I am going to record a new macro. So I click developer tab. Okay, then record the macro and type a name for your macro. Tamam. Okay, and press okay. The first step, we have to remove the subtotal. Okay, so the first step, click any cell in your header row, in this case A4. Okay, and from the data tab, select the subtotal. Okay, and click remove all. Now I remove the previous subtotal. Okay, the next step, we have to sort the data by the product name. Okay, so from the data tab, okay, select sort, and be sure my data has header is selected because I don't want to sort the header row. Okay, and I want to sort the data by the product name. So I select the product name and I want to sort it from A to Z, and I don't want the second one, so I select it and click delete level and press OK. Now I sort the data by the product name. Okay, the second step, I am going to create the subtotal. So I click data tab and subtotal from the outline group, and be sure from the add each change in, the product name is selected, and the sum function from the use function drop down list is selected, and from add subtotal to select the column that you want to add its values. In this case, I want to display the subtotal for the total column. Okay, and I want, if there is another subtotal, I want to remove it. So be sure replace current subtotal is selected, and I want to display the subtotal above the data. So I am going to uncheck this option, summary below data, and press OK. Now Excel displays the grand total for all the products and the subtotal for each product, as we see. Okay, then the last step, I am going to stop the macro. So I click developer tab, then stop recording. Okay, then I am going to create a new macro. This macro is going to remove the subtotal. So I click record the macro and type a name for the macro and press OK, and be sure to select a cell in your header row. So I select A4. Okay, and from data tab, select the subtotal. Okay, and select remove all. Now the subtotal is removed. Okay, the last step, I am going to stop the macro. So I select developer, then stop recording. Okay, the last step, we have to insert a button and assign a macros for the button. Okay, so I click developer tab. Okay, and insert command, then under form control, I click button. Then double click in your sheet. The assign macro dialog box will be displayed as we see. Okay, select your macro name okay, in this case brand and product subtotal, and press okay. Then type a name for your button, so right click your button. From the shortcut menu, click edit text and type a name for your macro, for your button. And resize your button. Okay, click any cell in your sheet. Now if I press the button, the subtotal for each brand will be displayed and its related product. Okay, to prevent the button from moving or sizing with the cells, right click your button. From the shortcut menu, click Format Control. From Properties tab, click Don't Move or Size with Cells. And press OK. Okay, and do the same steps with the other macros. Okay, that's it. If you like the content, please like the video. Thanks for watching and see you in another tutorial.